celebrate one of life's greatest moments, marriage of man and woman. Here to give recognition to the worth and beauty of matrimonial love. Here to celebrate the lives of Joe and Shayla, and esteem them, and rejoice with them as they start their journey in life together, hand in hand, heart in heart, as husband and wife. Marriage, the most honorable estate created, blessed, and instituted by God, signifying unto us the mystical union, which also rests between Christ and his church. It's a symbol celebrated not subtly through the pages of his word, which bespeaks of the love, acceptance, and commitment Christ has for his bride, the church. The writer of the Song of Solomon, a love poem found in the pages of his word, captures love so beautifully when he wrote, "My beloved is mine, and I his." Who is it that brings this woman to this man? Joe and Shayla, you bestowed a great privilege on me today. As your father, the minister of the Lord Jesus Christ, to preside on your marriage ceremony today. As you know, this is the first marriage ceremony I've presided on. And it's not lost on me. It is for my great son, Joe. And for Shayla, his lovely bride. We are honored to celebrate with you. And while this is the first marriage ceremony I've presided on, and obviously have much to learn as far as timing and details, words and transitions, I humbly trust that by seeking to walk with the Lord Jesus over 40 years and being married to my lovely bride of over 30, that I might humbly have a few thoughts that I can offer you to help you from this day forward start a growing marriage. To keep it simple, let's just use the word grow, shall we? To aid in the memory of our thoughts today. To foster a growing marriage, Joe and Shayla, I would encourage you to be gracious one with another. The word grace is a wonderful word. World over, it bespeaks of the offering of love, acceptance, promoting of goodwill, and blessing on one another in a purposeful, loving manner. Even though the recipient may at times not be quite so worthy of that grace and love. It's a beautiful day. We've come together to celebrate the best life has offered today, hosted in this beautiful Arizona setting by our wonderful hostess and host. It's a day of celebration, collaboration. We're carefree. We're rejoicing in God's best. With that, however, individually comes full recognition that we each have our flaws, our weaknesses. As you folks live under the same roof, week after week, month after month, those flaws will at times come out. You will see each other's weaknesses. And you'll be tempted at times to utter great judgment and criticism at the spur of the moment. I would encourage you, Joe and Shayla, let love be the preeminent emotion you have. Let grace exhale from your heart and your lips. Paul writes in Colossians chapter 4, "Let your speech be always with grace, seasoned with salt, so that you may know how you are to respond to each other." Joe and Shayla, in addition to having grace one toward another, I would encourage you to each be responsible to do your part in a growing marriage. Joe, manly responsibilities are not foreign to you. You know you are to take your lovely bride, to love her, to pursue her, to shower her with your love and tender kindness every day. God instructs the men to have loving servant leadership in the home. And Shayla, it is God's design in marriage that the wife would best thrive in that marriage by lovingly submitting to Joe and servant leadership, by coming alongside and encouraging, by loving. Another thought that might be helpful as you start a growing marriage is to be one-minded with one another. You know, in a few days, you'll be climbing aboard a large vessel, a cruise ship, for a well-deserved honeymoon. There is nothing more elegant in life than to see a boat confidently charting its course on life's sea, guided by a skillful captain. And yet, it would be of no avail for the captain and the first mate to each cling to that helm, refusing hold of it. Certain damage, loss, disgruntlement would arise. The parallel to marriage and to rearing of child, Joe and Shayla, is obvious. I encourage you early on, in your early days together as man and woman, as husband and wife, to sit down and chart your life together, to chart your love for the Lord and the important elements of life, the character that you wish to be still upon those children that God gives you. When the storm comes, and sadly they do come to all of us, remember that by being one-minded will help you keep your focus on those goals. And finally, I would encourage you to be willing to do all you can to lovingly support and grow your marriage. And I don't blame you for asking, say, I'm fully willing to do my part, but what exactly does that look like? May I offer these points for you? About being willing to admit when you're wrong. And at times, we are all wrong. I would encourage you to be willing to put aside your desires and wishes and do that which encourages and refreshes your mate. I would encourage you to be willing to do your part to keep the home and tend to the children. And Joseph, this will be especially refreshing and encouraging to Shayla. Finally, I would encourage you to never be willing to consider separation or cessation of marriage. Be willing to seek out godly, wise counsel should trials or questions come up through the years as you journey your life. Will you take these simple steps to grow your marriage today? I believe you will. And I can assure you that you will have a beautiful life together by doing this. Will you, Joseph, have Shayla to be your wife, to love her, comfort, and keep her, and forsaking all others, remain true to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Repeat after me. I, Joseph, take thee, Shayla, to be my wife.
I, Joseph, take thee, Shayla.
Before God and these witnesses, I promise to be a faithful and true husband.
Before God and these witnesses, I promise to be faithful and true.
Do we have a ring? As a symbol of your love and affection, place this on her hand. And repeat after me, if you will. With this ring, Shayla, I be wed along with all my worldly goods.
With this ring, Shayla, I be wed with all of my worldly goods.
I be endowed. Sickness and in health, in poverty or in wealth, till death do us part.
Sickness and in health, poverty or wealth, till death do us part.
It is my purpose, my joy, to willingly give you this vow today.
It's my purpose, my joy,
lasting for as many days as God does bestow upon my earthly life. I shall remain your one true husband, and you shall remain my chosen wife.
I shall remain your one true husband.
And Shelah, will you have Joseph to be your husband, to love, comfort, keep him, forsaking all others, remain true to him as long as you both shall live? Repeat after me. I, Shelah, take thee, Joseph, to be my husband. Before God and these witnesses, I promise to be a faithful and true wife. You have a ring. While placing it on Joseph's finger, repeat after me. With this ring, Joseph, I thee wed, along with all my worldly goods. I thee endow. In sickness and in health, in poverty or in wealth, till death do us part. It is my purpose, my joy, to willingly give you this vow beginning today. Lasting for as many days as God does give me upon this earthly life.
Lasting for as many days
as God does give me in this life. I shall remain your one true wife. You shall remain my chosen husband. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, creator of all that is good, you created man in your own image, formed his lovely wife, a helper for and throughout life. Thou, Lord, created love, that which draws man's heart to that of his bride, an amazing reminder of the love you have for your church. Today we're overjoyed at the celebration of the love that we see that Joseph has for his bride, Shelah. And we see Shelah having received that love reflected back as only a young bride can do. They've exchanged their vows today to join hand in hand, heart in heart, throughout their life's journey to live as husband and wife. Our dear Lord, we ask of you to bless this union. Bless it with love, deep and rich, unfailing. We ask of you that Joe and Shelah would love and serve each other, to love and serve you and those little ones that you bless them with. Bless them on every hand as they journey on the hilltops, and as you may occasionally lead them through the valleys. May their children grow and call them blessed for their faithfulness, both to each other as well as to them, their children, as they raise their children to love you and to live uprightly. God of love, God of grace, answer these humble, earnest prayers today. In the name of our Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen. As a minister of the Lord Jesus Christ, authorized by the state of Arizona, it is a pleasure indeed to announce Mr. and Mrs. Joseph David Hatton. You may kiss your bride. Thank you.